In sound recording and reproduction, equalization is the process commonly used to alter the frequency response of an audio system using linear filters. Most hi-fi equipment uses relatively simple filters to make bass, mid-tone, and treble adjustments. In this video, we will be showing you how to design your own equalizer using LabView and National Instruments MyDAC. As you know, all LabView projects have to be inside one big while loop in order for it to continue operating as long as the program is running. The user is to be given the option to start acquiring sound through a push button. This push button makes a case structure true. Inside this case structure is another while loop. The DAC assistant is the main block of the VI. Make sure to pick a sampling rate and buffer size that suits your application. Now, the signal is divided in three, depending on the frequency. You can choose the limits of each filter as you wish. By default, the sound is not modified. The bass controls the output of the low-pass filter, the mid-tone controls the output of the band-pass filter, and the treble controls that of the high-pass filter. All these outputs are added up together in order to create the full signal. Next, we have to work on the echo option. First, remember to change the wire from dynamic data to array of waveform, since the echo sub-VI will require a waveform input. The echo consists of a delayed signal concatenated with the initial one. In order to create the reverb effect, we have to control the amount of delay. It's better to leave the volume until all the changes have been made, so that we can control the overall signal's level. After the volume is modified, our audio track is now a change. It's mapped to the DAC output block so that the user can hear it. Our output is ready to be heard. It would be nice for a user to visually track the changes made in the frequency response of the original signal. This can be done by adding waveform graphs to the audio signal. We can choose to plot any two or three parameters depending on the user's needs. In this case, the user can check the amplitude versus time, the power versus the frequency, and the time versus the frequency versus the amplitude. The DAC assistant is the main block of the VI. It allows us to acquire the sound from a phone or an MP3 through an auxiliary cable which is connected to the audio in of the DAC. A USB connects the DAC to the laptop or PC for control using LabView, back to the audio out of the DAC, all the way to the earphones or the speakers.
Never gonna let you slip away.